He looks like a big turtle, or else he has to be an iguana. I wonder, said Pilgrim, who is his uncle? Hardly had he finished speaking when a man emerged from a bend downstream. Kneeling down at a distance, he cried, Great Sage, the water god of the Black River kowtows to you. Could you be that monster who rowed the boat? Said Pilgrim, returning to deceive me again. The old man kowtowed and wept, saying, Great Sage, I'm not a monster. I'm the true god of this river. It was the fifth month of last year, during high tide, that this monster spirit arrived from the Western Ocean, and he immediately waged a battle against me. An old and feeble person like myself could not withstand him, of course, and he therefore took by force my official residence, the Hengyang Ravine. Since he had also taken the lives of many of my water kin, I had no choice but to file suit against him in the ocean. I didn't expect that the Dragon King of the Western Ocean was his maternal uncle, who threw out my plaint and told me instead that I should allow the monster to stay in my home. I wanted to go to heaven to bring charges, but a humble deity and minor official like me would not get an audience with the Jade Emperor. When I heard that the Great Sage had arrived, I came especially to see you. I beg the Great Sage to exert his great power on my behalf and avenge my wrongs. When Pilgrim heard these words, he said, According to what you have said, the Dragon King of the Western Ocean is definitely guilty. Now this monster spirit has abducted my master and my younger brother, boasting that he wants to have them steamed and served to his maternal uncle for his birthday. I was about to try to seize this fiend, when luckily you came to inform me. All right, River God, you stay here and stand guard with Sha Monk. Let me go into the ocean to bring the Dragon King here so that he can capture the creature. I'm deeply indebted to the Great Sage's kindness, said the River God. Pilgrim at once mounted the clouds and went straight to the Western Ocean. He stopped his somersault and, making the water repellent sign with his fingers, he divided the waves and walked right in. As he traveled, he ran into a black fish spirit, holding a golden box and darting up like an arrow from the depths down below. Pilgrim whipped out his iron rod and gave his head a terrific blow. Alas, the brains burst out and the jaw bones cracked open. With a swish, the corpse drifted up to the water surface. When Pilgrim opened the box, he saw an invitation card inside on which this message was written. Your foolish nephew, Clean Iguana, touches his head to the ground 100 times to inform you, Venerable Mister. Ow, my esteemed second uncle. Frequently I have enjoyed your goodly gifts, for which I am most grateful. I have recently acquired 2 creatures, who happen to be monks from the land of the East. Since they are rare treasures in the world, your nephew dares not enjoy them by himself. As I recall that uncle's sacred birthday is near, I have specially prepared a small banquet to wish you the addition of 1,000 years. It is my earnest hope that you will honor us with your presence. This fellow, said Pilgrim, chuckling to himself, has handed over a formal complaint first to Old Monkey. He put the card in his sleeve and proceeded. Soon a Yaka on patrol saw him and darted quickly back to the Water Crystal Palace to make the report. Great King, Father Great Sage, equal to heaven, has arrived. The Dragon King Aoshun at once led his water kinsmen out of the palace to receive his visitor. Great Sage, he said, please enter this small palace and take a seat, so that we may present you with tea. I haven't yet drunk your tea, said Pilgrim. But you have drunk my wine first. Smiling, the Dragon King said, since the Great Sage has made submission in the Gate of Buddha, he no longer touches meat or wine. Since when have you invited me to drink? You haven't gone to drink wine, said Pilgrim. But you have committed a crime of drinking nonetheless. Greatly startled, Aoshui said, what kind of crime has this small dragon committed? Taking the card out of his sleeve, Pilgrim handed it over to the Dragon King. When the Dragon King read it, his spirit left him and his soul fled. Hurriedly going to his knees, he kowtowed and said, Great Sage, please pardon me. That fellow is the 9th child of my sister. because my brother-in-law had made an error in administering wind and rain by not releasing the prescribed amount, the heavenly judge issued a decree and he was beheaded by the human judge, Wei Zheng, during a dream. My sister had no place to go, and it was your little dragon who brought her here and had her cared for. Year before last, she died of illness, but since her son did not have a home, I told him to stay at the Black River where he could nourish his nature and cultivate the arts of realized immortality. I did not expect him to commit such wicked crimes. This little dragon will send someone immediately to arrest him. How many sons did your sister have? Asked Pilgrim. Are they all monsters somewhere? The Dragon King said. My sister has 9 sons altogether, but 8 of them are good ones. The first, Little Yellow Dragon, lives in the Huai River. The second, Little Black Dragon, lives in the Ji River. The third, Blue-backed Dragon, lives in the Yangtze River. The fourth, Red Whiskered Dragon, lives in the Yellow River. The fifth, Feudal Dragon, strikes the bell for the Buddhist Patriarch. The sixth, Reclining Beast Dragon, guards the roof beam in the palace of the Taoist Patriarch. The seventh, Reverent Dragon, guards the imperial commemorative arches for the Jade Emperor. And the eighth, Sea Serpent Dragon, remains at the place of my elder brother and guards the Taiye Mountain of Shenxi Province. The ninth son is the Iguana Dragon. Because of his youth and lack of official appointment, he was told last year to live in the Black River to nourish his nature. When he acquired a name, I would have transferred him to another post. I didn't anticipate that he would disobey my decree and offend the great sage. When Pilgrim heard these words, he smiled and said, "How many husbands did your sister have?" "Only one," said Ao Shun. "And he was the Dragon King of the Jing River who was beheaded. My sister lived here as a widow and died year before last. One husband and one wife," said Pilgrim. "How could they manage to produce so many different kinds of offspring?" Ao Shun said. "This is what the proverb means when it says that a dragon will produce 9 species, and each species is different from the others." Pilgrim said. "Just now I was so vexed that I was about to use the invitation card as evidence and file suit against you at the Heavenly Court, charging you with conspiracy with a fiend and kidnapping. But according to what you have told me, it's really the fault of that fellow who disobeys your instructions. I'll pardon you this time for the sake of my relationship with you and your brothers, and on account of the fact that that dragon is young and ignorant after all. And also, you have no knowledge of that matter. Quickly dispatch someone to arrest him and rescue my master. We'll then decide what to do next." Ao Shun at once gave this command to the prince, Moong. "Call up immediately 500 young soldiers of shrimps and fishes. Arrest that iguana and bring him back here for indictment. Meanwhile, let us prepare some wine and a banquet as our apology to the great sage." "Dragon King," said Pilgrim. "You needn't be so edgy. I told you just now that I would pardon you. Why bother to prepare wine and food? I must go now with your son, for I fear that master may be harmed and my brother is waiting for me." Unable to detain his guest with even desperate pleadings, the old dragon asked one of his daughters to present tea. Pilgrim drank one cup of the fragrant tea while standing up and then took leave of the old dragon. He and Moong led the troops from the Western Ocean and soon arrived in the Black River. "Worthy prince," said Pilgrim, "take care to catch the fiend. I'm going ashore." "Have no worry, great sage," said Moong. "This little dragon will arrest him and take him up here for the great sage to convict him of his crime. Only after your master has been sent up, also will I dare take him back to the ocean to see my father." Very pleased, Pilgrim left him and made the water repellent sign with his fingers to leap out of the waves. As he reached the eastern shore, Sha Monk, who led the river god to meet him, said, "Elder brother, you left by the air, but why did you return from the river?" Pilgrim gave a thorough account of how he slew the fish spirit, acquired the invitation card, confronted the Dragon King, and led troops back with the Dragon Prince. Sha Monk was exceedingly pleased. All of them then stood on the bank to wait to receive their master, and we shall speak no more of them for the moment. We tell you now about Prince Moong, who sent a soldier of his to go before the water residence and make this announcement to the fiend. Prince Moong has been sent here by the venerable Dragon King of the Western Ocean. The fiend was sitting inside when he heard this report and thought to himself, I sent the black fish spirit to present an invitation card to my second maternal uncle, and I haven't received any answer since. Why is it that my uncle has not come? Why has he sent my elder cousin instead? As he was thus deliberating with himself, a little fiend sent out to patrol the river also returned to make this report. Great King, there is a regiment of soldiers stationed to the west of our water residence, and one of the banners has these words clearly written, Young Marshal Moong, Crown Prince of the Western Ocean. This elder cousin is indeed arrogant, said the fiend. I suppose my uncle cannot come, and that's why the prince has been sent in his place to attend our banquet. But if he's coming for a banquet, why bring along soldiers and warriors? Aha!